And then, I don't know if that moment allowed me to recover a bit, get my brain, try to find another solution. I thought about my kids and I said, no, I cannot die today. For my kids, I cannot die. I've got to see them. And then I had the idea to twist my head like this, go up and turn my body, and it works, but then my foot is stuck on the pedal. So I've got to go back down in the car, pull as hard as I can on my left leg. I mean, the shoe stayed where my foot was, and my foot came out. And then I'd do it again, and I went through, and the shoulder went through, and at the time I knew the shoulder had passed the halo part, I was going to leave. You know, I know I've got two of my hands on the fire, on the halo. I can see my gloves, they're red normally, they start going full black, and I can feel the pain and the burn. But I'm going up, then I jump on the barrier, and then I feel Ian that pulls on my overall, and that is an extraordinary feeling. When he pulls me, I'm like, there's someone with me, I'm alive, and I'm gonna have. And then I feel like on my back that they touch me, so I'm like, oh, am I on fire? You know, I'm on fire from the back. And then I shake my hands because they're very hot. I remove my gloves straight away because I've got that picture from the movie where you see the skin, you know, melting and bubbling. And so I'm like, no, I don't want the skin to attach to the gloves. So straight away, I remove both of my gloves. And then Ian talks to me, say, sit down, you know, very as you would with anyone that could have had a concussion or so on. And I gave him shit. I say, talk to me normally. So I guess from that point he knew I was okay. And then we sit down and we're far too close to the fire. So we just said, no, let's go in the medical car. And then I sit in the medical car. And then I start, then they put straight away on my hands. They put those tissues, very cold tissues. And I start telling him, I need painkiller. My foot is hurting like hell. I need painkiller. And he says, it's going to be okay. And the ambulance, or he says, we need to wait the ambulance.